generation, meaning the PHP-based own cloud that is in the market today. We use that terminology to be able to clearly differentiate between this and the new generation own cloud infinite scale. So let's take a look at what I have for you today. First, I want to shed some light onto the highlights of product development in the last year. I will cover new features and improvements of the core product and of course also of the apps and our app ecosystem around the core. So a lot has happened also in terms of integrations with applications around the digital workplace. I will show and explain the most important ones here. And yeah, for the last part, I will talk about the way forward, giving you some details about OwnCloud Web, our new web interface, and also how OwnCloud Classic will make its way into the future. So yeah, let's get into things right away. We've made improvements in the area of security, especially for antivirus scanning, by supporting the ICAP standard in OwnCloud's antivirus app. Before that, our malware scanning capabilities were somewhat limited to ClamAV, that is the standard open source Linux antivirus scan engine. And yeah, enterprise customers usually have their own solutions in place when they decide for OwnCloud. And of course, they prefer using those tools also with OwnCloud, as they certainly had good reasons for choosing them. And yeah, the ICAP protocol comes in very handy here, as it's basically an open standard that is widely adopted among all the major antivirus vendors and products. So for the time being, we have developed and tested the integration with products from Kaspersky and McAfee. But as we are using a standardized protocol here, it is possible basically to support other products here as well without huge efforts. So if you're interested in using other products that support ICAP, you can of course get in touch with us, and we're happy to help here in any case. So the Metrics app is a new enterprise feature that has been released this year. The idea behind that new app is to help help administrators with application reporting for stakeholders. So for that, the app provides data, for example, about storage usage, sharing usage, and users also. You can get that, say, on a global basis, meaning for the whole OwnCloud instance, and also very granular for every user. So for simple use cases, administrators get an integrated dashboard integrated into the OwnCloud user interface, and that shows basically the current data set, and also allows to export that as CSV, so that it can be used to gather historical data and in the end to maybe visualize that and present it to stakeholders. For more advanced use cases, it also provides an HTTP API that can be used to automatically request the data in, say, certain intervals to store it and use it in external tools. And that brings us to another new integration. That's the OwnCloud app for Splunk. So Splunk is a, you might know it, Splunk is a very sophisticated CM tool that I guess many of you are familiar with. Recently, we have released an OwnCloud app for Splunk, That can be installed easily via the Splunk Base App Store. That's the own app store that Splunk has. Yeah, and what it does is that it automatically configures Splunk to ingest and store data from OwnCloud. That's on the one hand the reporting data from the metrics API I have just talked about, and on the other hand it also uses our audit logs. So with that, Splunk will request the data from OwnCloud in configurable intervals and store it for further use, first of all. On top of that, it comes with predefined dashboards that can visualize the data. So what you see here on the screenshot is the overview dashboard that provides lots of information about your own cloud, as you can see. You see storage and user growth over time, for example, top users, a world map, and yeah, logins by country, for example, yeah, and much more. So yeah, here you have a dashboard that allows you to report to stakeholders about the usage of an own cloud, and that almost in real time. So yeah, among other dashboards and also predefined alerts, there's also a very sophisticated auditing dashboard that allows basically to filter the audit log in the web interface to yeah, really find what you're looking for quickly. So you see that here in the screenshot, you can take a different perspectives on the audit log. You can filter it by time, you can filter by IP address, by users, even by actions or by particular files. Yeah. So of course you can also use other similar tools with the inputs that we provide. But the Splunk app, yeah, makes this basically an yeah out of the box experience that can also be easily extended or adapted with the built-in tool set of Splunk. So if you want to know more about this, you can check our website or directly have a look at the app in the Splunk-based app store. What's more, as you might know, OwnCloud provides the tooling to integrate Windows network drives, or also Samba storage, to make those available to users as part of their OwnCloud experience. So recently, we've seen a lot of interest in that functionality, as it yeah, basically helps unifying data silos and also yeah, to provide a single point of access to those for users via OwnCloud. So first of all, there's a new mode to integrate network drives, which we call collaborative WND. And in contrast to the existing or the previous mount mode, which we now use to call personal WND, the new one really makes sure that all users have the same file IDs in their mount points, so that they can also collaborate on the files, which was not possible previously. And they can do that by using, for example, our collaborative editing integrations, and they can also use private links to point others to files on network drives, for example. Apart from that, there is also a new integration with our activity feature that basically helps users to keep track of any changes that happen on network drives, even if they do not happen in OwnCloud, but directly on the network drive. And also, as we meanwhile have customers with several millions of files on network storages, we took a deeper look at the performance, especially of folder listings, which yeah, recently allowed us to decrease folder listing times, say from more than 30 seconds to about now 5 seconds, for a folder with 1,000 files. So yeah, the integration can also be perfectly used on larger storages with many files. And yeah, with the latest release, all credentials that are required by the integration are now stored encrypted in the database, which is, yeah, of course, a security measure yeah, that can be expected. With all these improvements, the integration is certainly worth a look, I think. Yeah, if you want to modernize your data infrastructures with OwnCloud. So, yeah, file lifecycle management is another new enterprise extension that helps service providers to comply with regulations or also corporate policies. The app provides a dedicated archive for each user and yeah, allows administrators to define policies to automatically archive files, say a certain amount of time after they have been uploaded. For the files that are in the archive, there's also another policy to permanently delete the files later. So while files are in the archive, you can either choose to allow users to restore them on their own, or you can have another policy that only allows admins to do that on request. So all this is nicely integrated in the UI and also in the activity and audit features, so that users basically know at any point in time what is going on, and you have proof in the logs for all the actions. So if you're, for example, dealing with personally identifiable data, or just want to keep control over storage usage, you should definitely have a look at our file lifecycle management app. Yeah, so far on the new features in OwnCloud Classic. So now let's have a look at integrations. And as you might know, we at OwnCloud really focus on our core competencies, and that's yeah, content collaboration and also content services. So if you haven't seen yesterday's talk about Infinite Scale, I would recommend to watch the recording, as we also explain there how we put the strategy on a new level and yeah, make it ready for the future. So taking that into account, I think it's of course very important to have strong partnerships with other vendors and other projects that yeah, have their expertise, say, in other areas of the digital workplace. So yeah, we have been working closely with Open Exchange. They provide an open source groupware solution, which probably most people in the audience are familiar with. Here we created an OwnCloud integration in their mail client that yeah, can replace large attachments with public links and can also store received attachments in OwnCloud. So this is currently being tested by some of our joint customers and will soon be available. On the right side, you see our integration with Matrix. Matrix is an open source chat solution, which yeah, has built-in encryption and also federation. So yeah, we have shared values here, so to say, perfect fit with OwnCloud. So for Matrix, we provide an integration that allows users to post files from OwnCloud as public links in chat rooms so that people can collaborate from there. Also, a very recent integration has been developed by our partner VNC. VNC provides a whole communication and yeah, collaboration suite with groupware, chat, project management, and much more. And OwnCloud can also be part of this stack and is then, of course, responsible for file collaboration aspects. So the integration brings OwnCloud functionality into VNC Talk, which is the chat solution in the stack. Yesterday there has been a talk by VNC that provided more details on the integration. So if you haven't seen that, I recommend to watch the recording. So we have also been working on Microsoft integrations a lot. There is a first integration with Teams that basically allows to do single sign-on with Azure AD, which is behind that, and to integrate OwnCloud, the OwnCloud user interface as a tab in Teams so that users can reach it conveniently. And for example, can get a public link to send that in a Teams channel. So currently we are in the submission process with Microsoft, and we expect the OwnCloud app to be available in the Microsoft App Source Store soon. For those who can't wait for that, we also make the app available directly so that you can install it manually in your Teams account. Yeah, and we're also developing an integration for Microsoft Office clients that allows users to open documents in their local Office applications right from the OwnCloud web interface. So this basically allows to use the rich local Office applications without having to download the files manually. So files will only be downloaded for temporary use and will be saved directly back to OwnCloud from Word, for example. So that is not only great because documents do not stay on the user's machines, but also, as you can see on the screenshot, because it also provides a nice usability for users. So this feature is not yet available, but it's expected to become available as an app together with version 10.9 later this year. So apart from that, maybe you know, we also support the online versions of the Microsoft Office suite for quite some time together with Microsoft's on-premises product, Office Online Server. And yeah, people have been asking us from time to time whether it would also be possible to use the cloud products from Microsoft. So up until now, we could only respond that, sorry, that it's basically technically possible. Microsoft offers a so-called Cloud Storage Partner Program, where you can apply to get your domain authorized to use Office Online. But this process, is unfortunately not really optimized for on-premises software, as you can only get a limited amount of domains authorized. So in the end, or practically, every customer who wants to use Office Online together with OwnCloud would need to apply there and walk through the QA process of Microsoft. This is, of course, possible, but it's also somewhat cumbersome. So to improve this situation, we have developed an Office Online proxy application that we will offer soon to customers to connect their OwnCloud installations to Office Online through the proxy. So yeah, we have meanwhile successfully completed the technical steps to become a Microsoft partner. So if you're interested in getting this functionality, just let us know, and yeah, we can start working on that together. So looking into the future, of course, our main goal is to shift all our current and future installations to the new product generations around OwnCloud Infinite Scale and OwnCloud Web. For the Infinite Scale backend, this will still take some time, as you have heard yesterday, but OwnCloud Web can be used in OwnCloud Classic installations basically today. So I want to advertise it a bit, of course. So if you haven't seen our new web interface, this is what it currently looks like as an overview. It provides a similar look and feel as the classic UI, but it comes with greatly improved usability. So users should really feel at home and also get used to the new web interface quickly. So all the main content collaboration features are available meanwhile. So you have things like file management and sharing. Those work really seamlessly. We have invested a lot in accessibility and are also in the process of getting certified for that. My colleagues Tobias and Benedict, they had a talk yesterday on that topic. So if you're interested, you can check that out. You can watch the recording if you haven't seen it. Branding capabilities are also available so that you can put your own look and feel on top of OwnCloud Web, basically as you know it from the classic UI. And we took care to make it easy to install the new web interface for administrators. So OwnCloud Web is available as an app in the OwnCloud Marketplace and can actually be deployed with very minimal configuration effort. So currently, we recommend to deploy OwnCloud Web as an addition, as a supplement to the classic UI, so that users can basically switch between both UIs. That's what you see here on the screenshot where it says new design. So yeah, as I said, we've reworked the user experience in many areas. Some examples are new quick actions for frequently used features, like for example, creating a public link on the fly with just one click, a new right-click context menu that is easily reachable for users. You see that on the screenshot. And also there's a new cool and neat copy and move feature for files. Adding to that, we are very proud of the good collaboration with our partners that also made OnlyOffice and Collabora Online also available to be used in OwnCloud Web recently. So OwnCloud Web is getting new releases basically every 3 weeks. So you can get new features and improvements, of course, also bug fixes on a very regular basis. And if you're using OwnCloud Web and find some issues, we can really react quickly on your bug reports and also without having to release the whole server. So you only need to upgrade the app, the OwnCloud Web app, to a new version to get fixes and improvements. So I'd like to recommend you to try OwnCloud Web either on our public demo installation, which is web.owncloud.com or demo.owncloud.com, as you see it on the slide, or even better, on your own OwnCloud installation. And provide feedback so that we can make it even better. There is an integrated feedback feature in OwnCloud Web for users, but you can, of course, always also reach us either via mail or you can use our public chat or Rocket Chat, that's talk.owncloud.com, to reach us directly. So, last but not least, I want to thank all OwnCloud users and service providers for the trust that you put in us. You can be sure that OwnCloud Classic will be maintained basically until the shift to infinite scale is completed. There's ongoing development, maintenance, bug fixing and security support. We're doing enhancements basically on a product and project and customer basis. And we will do basically everything to make the transition to infinite scale as smooth and also seamless as possible. So yeah, with that, I would like to thank you for the attention and wish you a great second day of the OwnCloud conference. Next up is Michael Stingel with news all around the clients. So if you have questions about this talk, you can find me in the Q&A room. Thanks a lot.